क्रॉसेस रोटेशनल प्योर रोटेशनल मोशन. एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ दिस डोर रोटेटिंग डोर rotating fan. These are examples. I think now you do make observation. What all we discussed, circular motion, it was for a particle. See in books what happened, they directly started with either moment of inertia, torque. Okay, fine. Everything is very easy now. Your teacher will teach some formula, some methods, still will teach some numericals. But when you go for numericals, no, definitely what happened, without background, you are going to be in a big trouble. That's why I'm starting with a different approach here, so that any numerical we should be in a better position. Today I'll describe even the rolling motion also. Just I'll give you examples. What should be the approach? First we'll develop approach, then we'll enter into topic. It'll be easier. Now rotative motion. There's any rigid body. So let me take there's a rigid body. And now let me take a disc here. So you are more familiar with such objects. It is rotating about an axis passing through its center. In fact, omega will be like this, no? And alpha will be like this. Now, different points will take it on the rigid body. So there's a point A. No, there's a point B. Then somewhere arbitrary point will take it C. Then you treat that point as a particle. So how the velocity of that particle should be? Tangential. And this will be RB bar. What is the velocity of this will be? VA tangential, this RA. Like this, I think we'll go for the tangential velocity we define. What is the basic formula for this? VB bar equal to omega bar cross RB bar. What about velocity of this particle? VA bar is equal to omega bar cross RA bar. All the particles will have same angular velocity, but different particles will have different linear velocity. Rather than saying tangential velocity, I'll call this as linear velocity. Linear velocity of particle B. What about this? Linear velocity of particle A. And what is RB? Position vector of the point B from the axis. Position vector of point A from the axis. And what about omega? Angular velocity. Like this we define all particles here, all points of a rigid body will have same angular velocity, same angular acceleration. Now, like this. So now if you go back to the plane diagram, so we used to, let's take one more example. So it is rotating. So we just do show omega like this here. So let's do one thing. Let me take a different points. There's a point one. There's a point two. There's a point three. What about the velocity of point one? Will be like this. Velocity of point two. And the linear velocity of point three. Well, why I'm showing all in same direction? Because what is the basic omega cross R? Of course, the position vector is different here. Since R3 greater than R2 greater than R1, greater than R1. So therefore, what will happen? The omega is same for all the particles. The angular velocity, they all will take same time to complete one revolution. All will complete after some time. Where do 1, 2, 3 will be there? After some time, the 1, 2, 3 will be here. I think please do notice all such. You take plate when you are eating lunch, no plate will be there. Just do rotate that plate. Do marking. And do rotate the plate, make observation. I think you'll be in a far better position. After some time, the point, they'll be here. So what is the velocity of this? V3, V2, this is V1. look at all the points, they're having same angular velocity, but they're having different linear velocity. So in a pure rotational motion, what will happen to if a rigid body is rotating, having pure rotational motion, all points will have same angular velocity. Then different points will have different linear velocities here. Let me take some other, one more example. Now let me choose point here. This is a V1. Omega, I'll show it. What about this particular point? It will have velocity V2 like this. What about angular velocity of both the particles? It's same. So what is the equation you can write? V1 equal to omega cross R1, or in a simplified way, V1 equal to R1 omega, V2 equal to R2 omega. Similarly here, V1, not only along same line. Now what about angular velocity of these two particles will be same. All points will have same angular velocity and the different particles will have different linear velocity. If it is, there is an angular acceleration also. Let me introduce, if a body is having, now what is axis? It is rotating about axis passing through center. Now let me take the rigid body itself. Now this is the axis now. Omega, this will be omega and this is alpha. What about the motion? How this, suppose if you take this particular point, this particular point, so it's going to describe a curved path above the axis. If you take this particular point, it's going to describe a curved path above the axis. I think I can draw a diagram only this much here. This is that point one, and this is that point two. So at this instant, I can show velocity V2 like this. At this instant, the velocity will be tangential to the path. What about the, this is about the pure rotation. It is rotating about an axis. The object is rotating about this axis of rotation. Now then what about here V1? So again, you can continue in the same way. V1 equal to R1 omega, V2 equal to R2 omega. Now what about the angular acceleration? Because I'm bringing alpha also into the picture. So the total acceleration of a point one, it will have both tangential as well as centripetal acceleration. Tell me, what is the tangential acceleration I should write? Alpha cross R1 bar plus. What about centripetal acceleration? Omega cross omega cross R1 bar. Is that okay? No. So this is what tangential, this is the centripetal acceleration. What about the total acceleration of this? Alpha cross R2. Since already you know circular motion, I'm directly writing it. So like this, we can predict the centripetal acceleration. And it should be negative sign we have to put it. Or let it be. Our R1 bar, R1 bar will measure from the axis to the point one. This is about the pure rotation. If a rigid body rotates about an axis, what happens if the axis is not passing through a body? It can also happen. No? If the axis is not passing through a body, how the motion of that will be? So if this is the rigid body, so this is the axis here passing through point O. About this axis, it is rotating that one. And now you see that the axis is not passing through any particular point in rigid body. The axis lies outside. What is this? Horizontal axis. So here, let me call this as X and Y. So here, this X axis, Y axis. What about axis? Z axis. The object is rotating about Z axis. This is a rigid body. So what is the example? No, rigid body rotates about z axis. Then you take some point 1. Now this will be the position of particle 1. Now look at the position of other particle. Let it be 2. This is the position vector r1 bar, this is r2 bar. How omega for our understanding purpose, I'll just show omega here, because it's a three-dimensional diagram. No. Now also, both the particles will have same angular velocity. What about the linear velocity? How linear velocity will be directed? Of this should be perpendicular to r1. This should be perpendicular to r2. Getting the idea, no? At two different particles sometime, after some time, where the object, this object will come here. This object will come here. So both the particles will have same angular velocity. Angular velocity of 1 with respect to origin is equal to angular velocity of 2 with respect to origin. And the origin, this axis is fixed here, no? About z-axis, they're rotating here. So like this, we can show linear velocity. So here the axis was passing through rigid body. What about your axis? Axis lies outside. So give example of this. You can take any notebook and whirl it. So I'm unable to show it here. Or I'll do one thing. We'll take in video. Now, what about this? Some of you will spin like this, no? Will spin here. So where is the axis? Axis is passing through the notebook here. Now, instead this, so I'm doing like this here. So what is axis now? What is axis here? So look at arm now. What is axis? My this one. This axis here. No? The axis will pass through this joint. And the notebook will be like this. You can see that one. Now the axis is not this one. This is not the axis here. So I can do like this also. No? Now the axis of rotation is what this will be. Look at the pen here, the digital pen, what I'm showing. This axis of rotation. So I'm stretching my arm. So now what happened? You can take your body itself. Of course, your body is not a rigid body. Assume it rigid body and try to rotate your arms like this. So now if I do like this here, now about what is the axis about which it is rotating your arm? This one. And can you say what is the axis here? This axis, no? Will be horizontal. So now look at this. Now you do like this here. Look at fingers, no? It is rotating about this axis. If you do like this, rotating about vertical axis. So do make observation of the axis here. So if the axis passes through rigid body or axis passes through about any other point, okay, there's a method what we have. Sir, similarly, can you write this equation? Let me bring alpha also. Then what about this equation? How A normal should be? A normal or the centripetal acceleration, I'll show it. Some of you are asking that one. A normal, and this will be A tangential. An2, and this is A2. What about the total acceleration? The total acceleration vector will be like this, and this will be like this. It all depends upon the value of AT1 and AN1. Rough diagrams I'm showing it to you. Like this, we can correlate all. So when rigid body comes, a point on a rigid body, you treat like a particle. And you know circular motion of a particle. Bring that idea. Look at now. If a rigid body is having pure rotational motion, all points will have same angular velocity, angular acceleration. What about tangential velocity? Different particles will have different tangential velocity and different particles will have different centripetal acceleration also. You look at AN and A2, normal acceleration, centripetal acceleration will be different. What about the total acceleration? Maybe equal, maybe different. It all depends upon the values and the position of particle. Got this? So this is about the pure rotational motion. And now translative motion got over, pure rotation. Next we'll pick up again, the rotation motion are of many types are there. if a rigid body, I will make it to rotate about an axis passing through its center. So this is called like a centroidal rotation. So now the same rigid body, can I also make it to rotate about axis which is not passing through its center of mass? This axis, so the dotted line is axis. Huh? Non-centroidal. Rotation. So fine. So this about the we'll get like this. How the axis should be even it can be need not like this. Even if there's a rigid body is there, no axis need not be always vertical. Even the axis can be like this also. Green that one, even the axis can be, it need not be always vertical. Even the axis can be like this. It can be axis of rotation, can be anything. So you do one thing, plate, you take it and go to kitchen, you take plate. Try to swing it about different axis. That's what the pure rotation. Do experiment today once. Huh? Okay, this is about the rotational motion. Now, general planar motion. The last one. That one, center,